When I edit, I like to really get vibe and the flow. You want to recreate that feel of being at a show where you're listening and you're looking and reacting to what you're hearing. You might be watching the singer, and then you hear the guitar solo start, and then you look over and you watch it. And I like to try and give that kind of a feel or vibe when I'm editing a project like this. It's dropping them all into the Multicam container. Kind of go in order of which ones are typically my favorite angles to use. Keep them grouped a little more closely together. Now that I've got all six laid out in the order that I want them, I'm going to press the button here that's telling me press to sync. And looks like they're all going to be lined up. You can see each one starting at a different point, and the audio mix is longer than the rest. Let's open it up in the switcher and take a look. So this is just a single song, and I'm just going to hit play and start editing based on what I would be looking at during a live show. Now that I've gone through the whole song and I've made all that first round of edits as if I were watching, you know, from the crowd, I'm gonna go back to the beginning and I'm just gonna watch it straight through and see how it feels. So there's one where I would move this edit back. I don't wanna change the camera I selected, but I wanna change the timing. And that leaves this shot a little short, so I'm gonna bring this back just a little bit more. There. This camera just happened to be swinging when I cut to it. So I want to choose a different shot to put in here. Really easy. I just click the back button to get to the beginning of this clip. And then I select the new clip that I want to cut to. And it just changes out that entire edit. Everything before and after that spot on the timeline remains. And I'm pretty happy with all the edit points. It still has that live feel and vibe, and some of those, you know, those whoops moments weren't in the first pass or cleaned up. Now, one final thing before we take it and show it to the band. When we filmed it, obviously the cameras recorded 16:9. We all had our frame guides up and we framed it for a nice 2:3:9 CinemaScope aspect ratio. So let's go ahead and create that just by going into the project settings, and it's set for 16:9. But I'm going to scroll down here for a nice 2:3:9:1 aspect ratio. Get out of the settings. And now you can already see that it's brought it down to that wider screen aspect ratio. So, you know, another nice touch that creates a bigger feel. And it's as easy as changing one item line in the settings. Now I think we're about ready to take it and show the band, but I like to screen things on my big screen before I show it to any client. I've been pretty impressed with not only the playback, the smoothness and how easy it is to go through and make the edits, but also how accurately the sync worked. It automatically synced everything up without any problem. It didn't take long at all to answer any questions I might have had about the capability. And then, you know, once you kind of figure a few things out in the interface, it's really easy to get up and going and put together, you know, some quick videos and, you know, the multicam stuff. It's really fast.